I'm a lead developer of PGCAM project, and we will be talking about photo management under Linux using PGCAM. Well, I will make a digital photography review and a project overview, especially if I would describe PGCAM the current version for KGO3, and I will describe the main interface and the camera interface, the editor, the old plugin interface available, the new tools named Lightable, and all search tools available. And I will review the new release. We will arrive in the near future. We will see what's new, especially the geolocation and all new search tools available. And we conclude. Well, the world of digital photography. For the last few years, the digital photography has been in revolution. Photography workflow is speeding up, and photography then increases in number and size. The hard drive are fully with a photo. And now, a photographer needs a real computer and a good software. And it's not only under Windows, and also under Linux, I'm sure. Well, computer as a photographer, use a huge image collection, and need to talk with the camera, all camera. Need to edit the photo, and cataloging and publish over the web. And there is a solution with PGCAM. The project overview. Well, PGCAM has been started in 2002. It's an international team with many contributors and developers. Open source, of course, coded in using C++ with Qt and Qt library. There are ARC, mailing list, Bugzilla, a web page, and a wiki. And currently, it's work fine with Linux. The goals: user-friendly interface. It's a priority. The photograph workflow must be respected everywhere. A camera interface, an album management, search tools everywhere, and the export tools to be able to publish over the web. All the GUI can be extended using plugin, and we are writing handbook with as a real book, and I would to publish as a real book paper in the future. Well, this is the last version for KGO3. There's many tools for photograph, album view, like this, currently, an editor, the camera interface, Lightable, and search tools. Like you can see here, all GUI use sidebar on the left and on the right. This is the main interface in preview mode. You can see an account view or a preview mode to display speedily your photo. on the left you can see a preview with your album. We follow the hard drive structure. The fast preview use a cache and speed up the preview. Charging tools. You can short filtering icon view content using these tools on the status bar. Sorry. You can comment all pictures, change that, apply tags and rating, and use a plugin interface. I will be talking about later. The feature for photograph is to display histogram everywhere, the metadata, using color profile, and geolocation. Very nice for the Cadio 3 version, but for the Cadio 4, it's very improved. Camera interface is a GPhoto 2 front-end. It supports a lot of camera. You can use USB and H3Z protocol, PTP. Proprietary protocol, and all downloading is performed using multi-threading. You can use many tools during download to autofix rotation and that, create album automatically, renaming file, marking exif data with your name, for example. And a very important feature is to convert in background to lossless format, especially for JPEG. RAW file is supported everywhere. This is the image editor. We have trying to make an easy to use interface. And we are working hard to support 60-bit color depth. RAW support, of course, thanks to Dave Coffin for GCO. Color management and metadata preservation everywhere. For Cadio 3, EXIF, Macronaut, and IPTC. And for Cadio 4, XMP. We use the EXIF 2 library in background to manage metadata. There is a plugin interface for editor. Yes?
You say metadata preservation everywhere.
Yes.
Also tips?
For TIFF, not yet. Because libTIFF, few features about EXIF preservation, but it will change in the future when EXIF 2 will support TIFF writing mode. It's under progress, and there is a standalone version named ShowPhoto of editor. It doesn't use a database. You can use the database to perform search and find pictures. There is many tools, especially RAW focus, noise reduction, red eyes, of course, changing fixed exposure and white balance, making transformation and composition, and apply decoration and effect, special effect. All tools use multi-threading, it's very important. This is the plugin interface. There are two plugins, one for the album view and one for editor. Here you can see the structure of the program. KP plugin is a plugin for the icon view. It's a separate project where I contribute. And Digicam, you can find the database, of course, and the main interface, the camera interface, and the editor, and the other one plugin interface dedicated to editor. For the main interface, KP plugin, you can export mail, web, and gallery server. Make a batch process. It's limited currently, but we will work to improve it in the future. And SciShow with Flash, DVD, or 3D using OpenGL. In editor, you have RasoProp tools, which this one, which provide a composition guide. It's very important for a photograph. There are many effects, like infrared or black and white combination. And the correction to restore the photograph, the old photograph, paper photograph, for example. And lens correction, and of course, the color correction. All tools support 16 color depth everywhere. The Lightable, it's come with this release for Cadia 3. It's a virtual container where you drop many similar images. That's the container is a toolbar, toolbar here on the top. And when you take similar picture, you can compare side by side on the left and the right with two canvas. That's you can synchronize to zoom and scroll pan, and there is a fast loading, and of course raw file are supported. Why? Yeah. To process sorting, selection, deletion, and writing pictures. Search tools. It's a limited part currently with Cadia 3, and for Cadia 4, we have rewritten all from scratch.
Will you integrate with Snapbook in Cadia 4?
Not yet, but I will talking about it. Well, Digicam use a database, a script database, to perform a search around the whole collection. You can find a photo by date, of course. There is a calendar view. And by time range, this is a new tool integrated with this version, the timeline. You can find a picture by your string, and make advanced search over the album, the command, the tag, writing, the date, and multiple query at the same time. On JRE contents, you can short idem using this and this and this. Album name, shorting metadata, and tag name, and trivia. This has been included with this version. And the future, the new release, which is still in alpha stage, it's designed for the new version of Cadia, and we have several improvements, especially we are using Marble widget for geolocation. Solid integration. Solid is an interface for the device. For now, integration to play multimedia file. With this version, we can use multiple repository with the the preview release, only one repository in local can be used. Now you can use more than one, and everywhere there is a network transparency. Remote storage, of course, network transparency, and a new database schema. It's always SQLite, but a new backend has been written, and we will use certainly other databases like MySQL, especially to support properly multi-threading. Currently, it's not the case. Currently, to carry the database, we use ChaosLake, and I think as a developer, it's not fine, especially to debug. New search tools. You can see we have working hard. Toolbar everywhere. You can see here in preview mode, you have toolbar on the bottom. And new tools to collect automatically the lens distortion. It's use the LensFun library. And new tools to capture image using your camera. XMP support is implemented everywhere. And of course the portability. This version already compiled fine and run fine under Mac, and Windows port is planned, but it's not the priority currently. We need to stabilize the code for Linux. Geolocation. Geolocation, it's I think it's an important feature, especially to be able to find a picture of our map. This is a feature that I will personally implement in the future. Currently, we have already several tools to synchronize a GPS device with a camera using the DAT. It's very simple. And the new database supports GPS information, and you can query the database to find some picture in the map over the world. All file format now can be recorded with GPS information. In the past, this is not the case. Only JPEG file can be tagged. And we have two tools for geolocation. There is a Google Map interface, this one, where we can edit the position manually, and Marble integration. With the Google Map, of course, you need a network, and Marble is a new program for Cadio4. It's Google Earth like. It's under development, but we can visualize the GPS information of our map with zooming and scrolling. Of course, we can export to KML. Yet, the to-do list, the search tools is in the map, and a tracklist viewer. The new search tools, very important work here. A new backend, fully overwritten. New database, more metadata are recorded in database. So we can find a photo using the photo property like aperture, lens tip, camera tip, etc., etc., like you can see here. Search tools are very important, especially to photo management. And in the future, we will implement database support over the network currently, especially to have more than one digicam session on several computer and an host computer where the database and all pictures are hosted, and all digicam session will carry the same server. The Nepomuk support, it's not yet implemented, but I'm sure that it's very important for the future. But it's not yet a priority. The priority is stability of the code. FuzzyCherche, it's we will use the AIR algorithm to be able to find pictures, duplicate pictures, or using a sketch painting like ImageSeq program. I think it's important. In conclusion, the goal to be the most easy to use, it's not easy, and to be adapt for casual photographer and provide advanced feature for professional photographer. It's not easy to mix both. The future, it's not yet implemented, but we will work versioning and action list support currently to be able to edit RAW and to be able to restore different stage of the editing. A backup tools, it's missing, it's very important. And a batch queue manager to be able to apply more than one operation at the same time to the whole collection. It will use action list feature. I'm also work to XSIF2 project, and we're currently working on TIFF writing mode support to be able to edit RAW metadata and also PNG. Currently, it's on read-only. And when all these features will be implemented, we will certainly toggle to the 1.0 version. There is other stuff to do, an initial web export tools, probably within Coherence project, but I'm not sure. And tedious stuff is DNG writing mode. That's all. You can find more information on GCAM website. I will review GCAM in live. This is the KDE3 version. I can it's a new implementation for this version is to be able to open a RAW and apply AutoGamma automatically to speed up workflow. I'm sure that photographer want to adjust perfectly all settings, but few others want to play directly with RAW, like with JPEG. It's this is the way using by Lizon. Look like this picture is a Canon RAW file. Is open in. This RAW file is open in 16-bit color def, and the image here is stored in memory with this color def, and all tools available here, for example, white balance, support SysBit CorelDRAW everywhere. You can adjust the exposure, for example. More. Yeah. Like this. You have many tools to preview the effect. For example, on move over, my preferred, like this. You can see exactly what you do. Here you can see two buttons to view overexposed and underexposed pixel. For example, like this. No, underexposed, just overexposed. Everywhere, in all tools, histogram is available. You will see the red eyes, my son. I will fix the red eyes. I just select the radar around the eyes. And I use enhance red eyes. Too fast. This is the correction. You can see the difference. Okay. And you can colorize the pupil like this. I want this color, for example. There is a bug. And I know this this problem. It's in CaderLib. Yes, it's work. And you can adjust the smoothness around the pupil. This is the raw effect. And now I adjust the smoothness just on the pupil, not on the other place. Another tools. The light table, of course. Now, to play with light table, I will use this one, for example. All are raw file. I select an image, and I will compare using added tool table. The tools is open. And we have two canvas. Both are synchronized, and I can zoom like this and pan like this. This is not a good example because the image is not exactly the same. This one. And zooming, with zooming, of course, we can see if the image is correctly adjusted and not blurred. And you can remove the wrong picture or tag. A single writing. This is a virtual container. You can put what you want here. New tools is timeline. I can select a range and see the result. And we have many square, time square. You can change by day, week, and year. And you see the histogram statistic computed in live. If you download at the same time from the camera, the histogram is updated automatically. You can use the camera and TARFAS at the same time of the rest of DigiCam. It's multi-threading. And you can perform multiple selection like this. I think it's work. Yeah. And of course, when you change the level on the bottom, the selection is adapted automatically. Okay, this is the KDHR3 version, sorry. And I will... this is the new version, and the famous marble widget. Okay. That's fine? Yeah? Look, you understand? Okay, now I will take a picture with geolocation taken in Iceland, like this. And look, the map changed automatically. Currently, it's the only stuff implemented. And I work with Marble team to improve this widget to be able to draw a zone over the map and process, of course, a church. It's a tedious stuff. No GPS. No GPS. No. This view is available everywhere: camera interface, lightable, editor, etc. Another tools. We will review the setting. This is this is not a good view. This is a new collection setting where you can set all main routes album path. Here you can set all the move path hosted by an FS server, for example. And the database file currently must be stored in local. And later, we will support remote hosting for database. Metadata, of course, XMP, XMP is supported everywhere. Is the same. That's all. Another tools. In preview mode, we have the toolbar on the bottom, and you can change the current one like this. This there is a cache in memory. Raw data. Well, I will play with this picture. It's a panoramic view taken in Iceland. I will edit this picture. It's a JPEG. Metadata. No metadata. The map. Okay. Here you can see the toolbar in editor, and I will fix the lens distortion automatically. This is the new tools using lens fan library. Of course, metadata are parsed automatically to find camera maker and model, and of course, this is a big problem currently. This is why the tools is not suitable as well. Is to find the right lens mounted on the front of the camera. This information is stored by marker note in EXIF. It's not an EXIF standard value, and we need hacking to find the right sentence for this lens. Okay, now I will use the right camera, and I will take a fish eyes lens. And yes, not this one. But this. Yes. Here you can see the correction applied to the picture, and several settings are not yet available, but in the future we will fix it. Only distortion and geometry fix are implemented.
Excuse me.
Yes?
What's the difference between distortion and geometry? I don't understand.
Good question. I don't know. This is a question for the lens fund author.
Okay.
It's a curious subject.
Well, I can. Actually, the example is not really that good, because if this is a panorama that has been stitched from multiple images, then.
Yes, of course. I have used this picture like an example. A better example is a picture taken from a monument, for example.
Yes.
But I don't have a picture from a monument.
Okay, yeah. But I mean, it doesn't make sense. Well, in an artistic sense, you can use this tool to warp images, but in order to correct the images, you should feed the images like they were photographed. So you shouldn't like warp them or transform them before.
Yeah. Yes, the vignetting fix. Yes, it's the planet to fix it automatically.
Yeah.
And you have another tools which already exist, but it's manual stuff.
Yeah.
And this is, I'm not sure if it's stable. And it's vignetting. Yes, no. Yes. Here you can see a preview of the mask used to fix the picture. And it's not a good example. You can see here and here that the exposure X is fixed, corrected. I can change the density. Yes. But it's not automatic. Very important feature is the new advanced search tools. I will reduce this one. I'm sure that this church feature are important for photographs. For example, the exposure time, or the lens aperture. And when you have set our church feature, you press test, and if something is found, it will display the in the view. There is nothing to see. because there is a creature. No, nothing. It's missing a button to reset each parameter. Wrong. Missing a button. Of course, the query is performed over the whole collection, or if you want, especially an album or a tag album. Reset button. Another question? Yes.
When you convert them to, let's say, JPEG, then you...
Okay, if you convert raw photos to JPEG images, and then you have two, the raw image and the JPEG image in the same folder, so I try to use DigiCam, like, just put them in my folder, and I see all these duplicate and images. And is there anything that I could do about that?
Yes, it's planned to manage JPEG and RAW at the same time. Yes, this is what you want, I'm sure. You taken your photo with your camera with the both format at the same time, and you want to see only one hidden for
yes.
the same photo. Yes, yes, it's planned, but it's not yet implemented. It's only the database schema is ready to use, but the interface is not yet ready for that.
Okay, so
that's
coming.
Yeah.
I've tagged around 2,000 of my own photographs, and I've never used DigiCam. I would be concerned about using any program that can't guarantee to keep my tags a long time. I wonder what you think would happen in 50 years or 40 years or 5 years once my photographs have been moved around a few times from hard drive to hard drive to CD. How likely is it the tags will follow them? Can you bake the tags back into the JPEGs, for example, into the EXIF tags? Is that something that worries the digital community?
Yes, you want to be able to find in the future all tags that you have used in DigiCam with an old version. And to be able to use it in another program, it's easy. We will you can record all tags in the metadata for pictures.
Is there perhaps are there any standards with how to record metadata from various programs, including online systems such as Flickr and Facebook?
Yes, yeah, is an
interface. Uniting all these tags.
Yes, there is an interface to export metadata. To the web, that it's under construction. This is what you want?
I guess I don't want it to matter too much which program I'm using to add tags, but to later be confident that I can reunite all my places I've been tagging and have some confidence that they'll hang around and they'll last a long time. I won't lose these tags.
I'm not sure to understand.
I guess I'm
savoir s'il peut stocker les tags à l'intérieur du fichier, comme ça, s'il utilise une carte ou une autre application.
It's already the case. You can do it. It's already implemented. It's already implemented with JPEG and for other format like TIFF, RAW, and PNG, it's under construction from EXIF to Library. There is no metadata interface, low-level metadata interface in Digicam. We use EXIF 2 for that. Currently, only JPEG can be written, metadata can be written in JPEG, in live. And TIFF writing mode is under construction. And it will be ready to use for the next release of EXIF 2. And I will personally implement the PNG writing mode to be able to change metadata without to reconstruct or re-encode the whole image, of course. PNG is, for me, the better format to use under Linux because it's lossless. And you can store all metadata type like EXIF, Archernaut, PTC, and Kimby. The TIFF format like under Linux, like several information from EXIF, it's a problem with libTIFF library. And when EXIF2 library will support TIFF writing mode, you can use TIFF like PNG. Personally, I store all my pictures in PNG format.
Can I ask another question on another subject? About the geotagging of photographs. It concerns me that there's much geotagging goes on without any care as to the accuracy of the geotag. So if you go to Google Earth and switch on the photograph layers, you get hundreds of photographs that are 100 meters or even a kilometer away from where they say they are, because people don't know how, they haven't been able to place an accuracy tag on the geotag. So, for example, when you tag on a Google Earth API, you tag to double precision, whatever your zoom level. So that's 16 significant figures of accuracy, when only maybe 5 significant figures is useful. Is there some accuracy information that you can encourage people to add when you record geolocation?
It's planned. It's not yet implemented. But the database is ready for this to host this information, but it's not yet implemented to use it properly. The future.
Maybe the last question, because we will have to finish soon.
No?
No.
Nothing? Thank you.